Yes, students, write down the topics for writing skills, which are there in your syllabus, and on the basis of these topics, we'll be doing some MCQs. Okay. So first of all, it is a formal letter based on a given situation. Word limit should be 100 to 120 words. And second question is writing an analytical paragraph. Writing an analytical paragraph based on the given map based on the given map, chart, report, graph, so word limit is again 100 to 120 words. So these two are topics for 5 marks each in your syllabus for this term. So if we talk about formal letter, so write the questions in the form of MCQs. Through that, you will be having an idea of your formal letter also, right? Write on. Letter to the editor of a newspaper. Letter to the editor of a newspaper is an example of dash. Letter to the editor of a newspaper is an example of dash. The options are business letter, formal letter, descriptive paragraph, report writing. So did I give the option formal letter? Yes, so answer is formal letter. It's a formal letter. Next question. The formal letters start with the header. The formal letters start with the header, H-E-A-D-E-R, header, as dash. Options are receiver's address, write on. Options number one, receiver's address, subscription, third option is salutation, and fourth option is you people tell sender's address. So the formal letter starts with the sender's address. In the previous question, where I told you like letter to editor is an example of dash. There I gave you business letter and formal letter. Business letters are also formal letters, but all formal letters are not business letters, right? Okay, so even business letters start with the sender's address. Same is here, okay? So header, that is the, these letters start with the sender's address. Now, next question. Sender's address in the formal letter is followed by dash. Sender's address in the formal letter is followed by dash. Sender's address in the formal letter is followed by The options are salutation, salutation, content, date, subject, date. What's the answer? Date. And what's the best way to write date? Write on this also. The appropriate way to write date in the letter is dash. The appropriate way to write date in the letter is dash. The options are number one. Today is which date? This is first option. Second option is third option is and fourth option is so what's the correct answer? Yes. In sequence, date, month, and year. For letter writing, this is the correct, best way. Okay, next question. The date in the former letter is followed by dash. The date in the former letter is followed by a dash. Options are number one, salutation. Number two, content. Number three, receiver's address. Number four, sender's address. Okay, so what's the answer? Receiver's address. Write down these statements. Keep on writing all statements. Okay. Next question is and the receiver's address is followed by the receiver's address is followed by dash. The options are Saksham will give the options. Got this. Are you Saksham or Saharsh? Saharsh? What's it? Why are you not writing? What's the question? Now give the options. Okay, what's the correct answer? Is that clear? Is that right? Receiver's address is followed by subject. Written? Okay. Next sentence. The subject should be dash. Options are descriptive, second option, brief but informative. Number three, brief and informative. Brief and informative. Number four, impressive. Brief but informative, brief and informative. Brief and informative. Brief but informative. What is better, brief but or brief and? But, because the main thing is like the main idea of what you are writing about, that should be there. And you have to remember like it should be brief also. But if you're writing it very brief, doesn't mean that you ignore the main information. So no doubt, brief, very important, but at the same time, information should be there, complete. Okay? So model number, order number, date of purchase, and the actual problem defect. So the words, main keywords should be there. Okay, sometimes children feel like I don't have to write a big subject, so they don't give complete information. So you have to remember like complete information can be in very brief subject as well. Okay, there you can ignore the subjects, sorry, verbs or articles. Okay, so there are so many things, there are so many ways through which you can write a brief subject. But it should be complete, right? Now next sentence, next question. The subject should be written in bracket word, options are capital letters, small letters, what should be the more options? Italicized. Then there will be two correct options. What is the meaning of block letters? Capital to ho gaya. And a block capital means same thing. Italicized. Or in stylish or in calligraphic mode. Calligraphic. Small letters? Subject should be in capital letters. Each word better. If you write the whole subject in capital letters, better. Because that is the sum of your whole letter. Okay? It's not a hard and fast rule. But if you get these kinds of options, then you go for capitals. Okay, your whole letter is going to be in small letters, basically. Isn't it? Otherwise, the whole letter is going to be in running, in what we say? Sentence phrase, running hand. Okay, and running hand is always in capital, small letters. But subject is the sum total of your whole letter. So that is just one sentence. That is somewhat like a title that can be written like in capital or block letters. Okay, there is a logic behind it. Otherwise, there is not any hard and fast rule. But from these options, what would be correct? Capital letters. Okay, next question. The content of the formal letter has these three parts. The options are number one, introduction. First option, introduction. Introduction, developing the thought or idea. And third, conclusion. Introduction, developing the idea and conclusion. Second option is introduction, elaboration of the introduction, elaboration of the introduction. What will you write after this? Okay, conclusion. Conclusion of the conclusion. Okay, third option. What is more difficult, giving correct answer option is give you difficult or difficult wrong ones? What is more difficult? Even giving wrong option is equally a difficult task, because they should also be somewhat like the correct options. Okay, have you got the correct answer so far? First option, because it was about introduction, developing the idea, then conclusion. Right, third option. Purpose of writing the letter. Purpose of writing the letter. Description of the problem. Description of the problem in brief. Offering a solution. Offering a solution. Then conclusion. Offering a solution, then conclusion. Number four option. Introduction, middle, ending. So what's the correct answer? First, introduction, okay, sure. Why not third? I said three. Okay, remove the word three. Now you tell. What was the question? The content of the formal letter has these parts. Ab batao. Because now I have deleted three words, that's why. Or otherwise also it is more suitable. It is a little bit more concise, clear. Like what is to be written in the introduction? Purpose of writing letter, that is very clear. So when we have written the purpose, then the problem is to be given the details. And finally, if the problem is there, solution is to be given. And after the solution, of course, we have to conclude. Right? So this is the correct answer. So there is no hard and fast rule like what kind of MCQs the writer will be giving you. You'll have to apply your mind. You have to solve, do some practice of the writing skills, only then you'll come to the conclusion. Okay, now write. In a letter of placing order, in a letter of placing order for a product, in a letter of placing order for a product, the writer will mention options are details of the draft. Details of the draft or check, comma, details of the draft or check, comma, model number of the product, model number of the product. and self-address. Self-address. Write down, Chaitatya. So what did I say, Chaitatya? Three words I said in first option. What was it? Yes, Khushi, repeat. Got it? Now B option. Self-address. What shall we say? Okay, details of the check or draft, comma. Insurance, details of insurance policy. Details of insurance policy. Got it? Now third. Out of these two, what is correct? First. Why not second? Because the customer will not ask for insurance policy. He will ask for, but he will not give the details of insurance policy. Is that clear? He will give the details of his own address, the check which he is giving, and what else? Model number he will ask, like he will tell, like, this is the model number I want. Okay, and what in return he will ask for? Of course, insurance policy he can ask for. He can ask for a warranty card. Okay, he can ask for, yes, anything else, what he can ask for? Details of the delivery, details regarding delivery of the product, like when will the product be delivered, how will it be delivered, when will it reach his home. Okay, so that is what you people do when you go for online shopping. Okay, so do the correct answer, take the correct answer. Okay, next question is, while ordering for a product, the customer should, option number one, discuss the discount. The customer should ke baad option starts like this. Discuss the discount. B option, not discuss the discount, as it is already discussed. Third, tell the discount available on the product. Okay, what's the correct answer? So when you are ordering for a product, then at that time should you tell about the discount? Should you talk about the discount? Out of these three, one is like tell the discount, when you are ordering for the product, first option, what's the first option? The customer should discuss the discount, should not discuss the amount, discount, or the customer should tell the discount available on the product. Should discuss. When you are ordering, it means that already the things you have discussed. Already everything has been discussed, or already the things are final. Okay, only then you place order. For example, when you order for Zomato, for something through Zomato, what happens? Can anyone tell me, like, what happens then? Okay, Thavnesh, shoot it. Yes. You place order in the end after having gone through all the options, like the places where the discount will be admissible, isn't it? Or you do like this, like you purchase, you go for the, you place order, and then you start calling the person like, sir, will I be getting the discount? Does it happen? So discount and all are already finalized. Is that clear? So same is for purchasing. If you go for any purchase, first the things are finalized. Then you say, okay, pack this one for me. Doesn't happen like, okay, you pack this and they start sending it. Then you say, okay, now tell how much discount will you give us. Does it happen? No. So doesn't mean that when you are purchasing something, when you've ordered, then you start telling the shopkeeper like, I want 20% discount. That is wrong and unethical. Before you finalize, before you place order, you finalize the discount. Or the things are already clear. Okay? In the branded products, the things are already clear. Okay, it is only when you go for some unbranded shopping, then you know there is some sort of, you know, bargaining, and that bargaining is also done beforehand. Not after you have purchased the things, you have kept the bag in your car, and then you start telling the shopkeeper, okay, how much discount will you give us? It doesn't happen. Or does it happen? Yeah, if some people do like this, then I can't say, but that's not the rule. Right? Even when you buy the vegetables from the hawkers, then even then what happens? First you discuss how much discount that person will give you. If he says that some vegetable is 50 rupees per kg, then you say, no, I'll give 40 rupees. Then he says, okay. Then you get it done. Doesn't mean that you first get it done, put it in the car, then you say, okay, I'll give you 40. First, the things are finalized before placing order. Very minor thing. And this question, this statement, you know, many children do this thing wrong in the letters. When they write letters for placing order, they have done everything in the end. Okay, now I want 50% of discount. That is ethically wrong. Marks are deducted for that. Okay, now next question. While writing a letter of complaint, the customer should write in a next language, now option number one, friendly and courteous manner. Second option, courteous but formal manner. Courteous but formal manner. Number three, formal and harsh manner. Number four, courteous. Formal as well as straightforward. As well as straightforward. What is totally wrong? First is totally wrong. Friendly manner is absolutely wrong. And you should not be writing the letter in a very friendly manner. Second option. Formal as well as harsh. Formal and harsh, that is also totally wrong. Harsh language no one will tolerate. Okay, and one should not write. Whether that person tolerate or not, that's a different issue. But one should not be harsh in write-up. Third is formal, courteous, and straightforward. That is best option. Okay, one's language should be formal, courteous, as well as straightforward. Yes, children, were the things clear, online students? Okay.